Hey, it's Sam Backer here, and I'm sure you've heard about InstaBuilder. Now, InstaBuilder 2.0 is about to come out, and I'm really excited about this one because this is a software that's proven in the market, thousands of people use it, and it makes it really easy to build sales pages, landing pages, membership pages, everything, funnels, anything you could think of, InstaBuilder has the ability to do it. Now, the InstaBuilder team have actually prepared a really cool walkthrough video, and I was going to show you this myself, but after watching what they've put together, the best way that I can show you InstaBuilder in action is actually passing it on to Chad to show you how the software is going to make it really easy to get online and start selling your products, services, and because I've been so impressed with the software, I've decided to put together one of my biggest bonus packages ever. Go down below to find out more details about this launch, find out more about my bonuses, and how you can get access as soon as this comes out at the best price. Cool, take it away, Chad.
Okay, guys, so I'm in the back end of WordPress. I have created a page. Now, see this button over here that says Enable InstaBuilder? I'm going to go ahead and turn this on, and I'm going to launch InstaBuilder 2.0. Now, here's the templates I talked about in the slides. Sales pages, squeeze pages, launch pages, webinar pages coming soon, and there's other pages as well. Okay, thank you pages, download pages. Everything's here, guys. Remember what I said in the intro slide? There is going to be 100 templates that go down with this launch. So we'll go ahead and choose sales page. And look at these templates. They're beautiful. All different kinds of styles. We have flat designs. We have the fancy backgrounds. Everything that you guys would expect in a top-notch editor, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this guy right here. Now, watch how fast this is, okay? You're gonna see that throughout this whole demonstration. This page builder is fast. And that's very important, but more importantly is how easy it is to use. It's basically a three-step process. Now, you can choose a template like I just did, or you can start from a blank canvas, okay? So, with a three-step process, you choose your template, you drag in elements, and then what you do is you click on the element itself, and you have settings for that element. Three simple little steps. This is nothing complicated, no rows, no crazy tables, nothing like that. Very easy, okay? So this element here, which is a text element, I'm gonna go ahead and click it. As soon as I do, there's the WYSIWYG editor. We can go ahead and change it on the fly. Notice there wasn't another little pop-up window that opened here on the side or anything. You really do change it on the fly, okay? And then we can go ahead and highlight this. We can do everything you expect with a WYSIWYG editor, okay? Now, if we wanna move that below the video, boom, look how fast that was, guys. I know you guys have seen these page builders where it just sits there and it spins before it actually generates the element. Well, not with InstaBuilder 2.0, and this is what I love about this software, okay? Now, these are all the elements over here, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and scroll through them real quick just to kind of show you, okay? Text elements, image elements, video, box, horizontal lines, countdown timers, button elements, opt-in forms, three-step opt-in, comments, social share, tab content, navigation, today's date, surveys, and then there's boxes for HTML and CSS. They've also got more elements coming in here, okay? They're not even done creating this software yet. It is sick what it can do. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and show you how fast these elements come in, right? I'm not gonna salt you because I know you guys know how this works, okay? If we wanna bring in an image, we can bring in an image. We click here, look how fast this thing opens up, guys, okay? So over here on the right-hand screen, that is the properties for that specific element, okay? Now watch how fast I get rid of this. Boom, it really is that fast, okay? Countdown timers, watch this. I'm gonna bring this in, there's a countdown timer. Remember what I said about editing the elements. I'm gonna go ahead and click this. I'm gonna come over here to the settings, check this out. Obviously, we can go through here and set our countdown type, our text label, everything that you would expect, okay? That's cool. Now, design, all right? We have some options for design. I can say fancy text. I can say flat box, that happens to be my favorite. Glossy box, circular, okay? I love the circular, check that out. But now maybe this red is not right. So we can come over here, we can change the font color. Check that out. Now that's pretty cool, right? We can come over here and we can actually, let's go to the other design real quick. Let's do flat box, okay? We can change the background color of the flat box. All right, I have not seen this with a timer yet. I was actually getting ready to develop a plugin that would do just this. Well, they've already beat me to it, okay? Then we can go and we can change the border color. We can change everything about the countdown timer, but guess what? When a countdown timer ends, you need it to do something. So we can come over here, we can open this up, and we can say hide the countdown timer after it expires, redirect the user to another URL, or you can even reveal hidden content. Guys, there's so much you can do with this drag and drop editor. Okay, now watch this. Remember I told you there's some serious magic happening with the two-step opt-in? I absolutely love this. If I go ahead and bring in a button, now obviously you know that I'm gonna have full control over this button. Okay, I can come over here to the settings. I can change my button text, all right? Everything you'd expect. It can change the font. We can change the style to flat or glossy. I'm gonna go ahead and leave it flat. Okay, we can come over here to the normal state colors. We can go ahead and choose different colors for our button, right? That's how fast I'm changing things, okay? We can come over here to the hover colors. So if you want your button to be a different color when it's hovered over, we can just make it like yellow, right? I'm not to the magic part yet. Icons, we can go ahead and put icons in front of the buttons. Very easy to do, very effective, okay? Rounded corners, all right? Everything's here, guys, but check this out. This here was absolute genius in my opinion. Any button on the page, this guy, any single button can be a two-step opt-in. Watch this. I'm gonna come over here, instead of having it go to URL, I'm gonna have it go to a pop-up. And now I can click on Edit Pop-up, and this is the pop-up window that's going to occur when the user clicks the button. Now, what can we do with that? Well, let's go ahead and drop in a title element, and we'll click this, and we'll go ahead and center this with our WYSIWYG editor. And now let's just go ahead and drop in an opt-in form, and I think you guys are starting to see what we can do here. That's how fast we can make a two-step opt-in, right? I absolutely love that. That is a major selling point to InstaBuilder 2.0. Genius, all right? And I will definitely use that myself, okay? So let me go ahead and delete some of these options here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and change templates really quick. We can do that just by coming over here to change templates, okay? And I'm gonna go ahead and choose something else, all right? I'm gonna go ahead and choose, say, this guy right here. I'm gonna say choose, okay? Now I'm kind of starting over, so let me delete this, and I'm gonna delete this, okay? Now, remember what I told you about the three-step opt-in? Watch this. I bring that in, boom. This is how the three-step opt-in works. Obviously, you can go ahead and change everything about the headline. We can change everything about the button. I just showed you how to do that, but watch this. See this little arrow that occurs over here? If I click that arrow, now I'm taken to a video. Obviously, this is an element, so we could change out the element if we want, but if I come over here as well, I can come over here to the next arrow, and there's your three-step opt-in. Here's an opt-in form that can completely be customized for your own use. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a three-step opt-in. I just think it's brilliant what they've done with this software, and you can see how fast and how responsive it is, okay? Because that's one of the most important things to me. Comments, boom, that's how fast we bring in Facebook comments. Social sharing, there we go. And remember, we also have options, okay? I open them up over here. We can set big ones, we can do small ones, we can turn off Twitter, we can turn off LinkedIn, okay? You're seeing how fast these changes are happening, okay? Tabbed content, if I bring this in, I have tabs, okay? So then what I can do is I can change the content under each one of these tabs. So we can drop in images, we can drop in other elements. Okay, let me go ahead and delete these real quick so I don't wanna lose anybody here, okay? We also have navigation, okay? So I can go ahead and drop in my navigation. Now what this is doing, if we go ahead and click this, so come over here to settings, this is tying to your WordPress menu. So you pull this down and you have this drop-down menu here. So you would choose the menu that you have set up in WordPress. So you see that I have four items set up, okay? And then we can go ahead and choose different menu styles. We have plain, we have pipe, we have flat box. Obviously, we can change the colors, right? Look how fast I'm making changes to this. We can round the corners, complete control over your menu. You can even change your submenu style. Guys, everything is here that you could possibly want. If you want to drop in today's date, we can go ahead and do that. Okay, we can click it, come over here to the element. Do you see the simple steps that I'm following? I'm dropping in the element and I'm coming over here to the settings and I'm making changes and boom, you are seeing it happen instantly. Surveys, if we want to put in a survey, if we want to change that, we can do that, okay? Everything is here. So that kind of gives you a rundown of how the elements work. All right, now, see these guys up here? Section, wide section, and wide background box. All right, this is how this works. Now, if we look at this page right here, we have these wide designs, right? And you guys are seeing it on all the sales pages and everything else. They work very well. This software does things a little bit different than any other page builder out there. And I'm very familiar with the other guys. So if we want to drop in a wide section, check this out. I just now dropped in this wide section. Now I can come over to the properties for that section and I can go ahead and set the margin and padding. Okay, I could set the background, which you're gonna absolutely love this. Obviously we can set a background color, but if I come over here to action guys, I can go pre-made patterns. All right, now look at this. This is how fast I can go and change out that pattern, right? These are all included with InstaBuilder 2.0. That's how fast we can do this. By the way, if we like that, we can actually clone this. We can bring this guy down here, that's fine, and then we can go ahead and change the color. So you're starting to see how easily you can create those high converting sales pages that we've been seeing online, right? It really is this simple with the click of a mouse. Okay, we can also do the same. We can bring in a box and we can change out the background and everything. We can put as many elements as we want in the box. Most of you are more familiar with the term create a row. It's doing the same exact thing. Okay, everything's here, but I've got one more thing to show you. I think it's pretty cool. But before I do, if we come up here to the top, you'll see that we have some options up here as well. So we can put in an attention bar. And if we scroll up to the top here, you can see here is our attention bar. Your attention grabbing message, click here, and we can go ahead and change the color to whatever we want. Okay, that's pretty cool. We can come down here to pop-up settings. Okay, so you can have a pop-up occur every time the page loads, first time visit only, once a day, once a week, once a month. All right, everything's here for your pop-ups. Exit splashes, we have that welcome gate. Okay, remember this is a page that will be locked to the landing page that you're working on. Also, we can come down here to graphics and you see that we have all of these graphics that we can just go ahead and drop into the page really fast, real responsive, right? We got buttons, badges, buy buttons, icons, big icons, highlights. Guys, look at all the stuff in here, right? Arrows. I mean, and it's fast. That's what I love about this is how fast it is. Now, if I click on this graphic here and I come over here to the settings, guess what? We can go ahead and change things on the graphic as well, okay? Guys, this is awesome. And also, remember, we can also publish it to a Facebook page. And more importantly for me, we can publish this to HTML, right? Awesome stuff, but let me show you one more thing. I'm gonna change the template and I'm gonna come over here to the squeeze pages. So let me go ahead and choose this guy right here. Now I thought this was awesome, okay? So here's a squeeze page, all right? Now if I click on the element box, I'll bring my settings over here. Now the same features are here that we're used to seeing, okay? We definitely want that because we want the software to be easy, right? Margin and padding, backgrounds, borders, rounded colors, opacity and shadow. But this is brand new. See where it says display delay? If I open this up, what we can do is we can enable the delay. So what's going to happen is the page background is going to appear first, and then we can go ahead and delay the opt-in box showing up. So the page opens up, and then according to this, in 18 seconds, the opt-in box itself will display. Now, how clever is that? Because I have never seen that before. I thought that was pretty awesome. And you see how fast you can do that. Also, throughout all of InstaBuilder 2.0, something I forgot to tell you, is there's also animation. So you can set buttons to blind, bounce, clip, drop, explode, fold, highlight, puff, pulsate, scale, shake, slide, list goes on and on, right? When we're ready, if we go ahead and save this, okay, that's how fast we save it, we can then preview this, okay? So we can see exactly what the page is going to look like. Remember, it's on an 18-second delay, and you have the ability to preview how it looks on mobile phones, iPads, things of that nature. Okay, so you can see that this here is just a beautiful template. There is the opt-in box itself. By the way, we can also put the opt-in box over here on the left-hand side. So if I click this here, I can go ahead and click here. It's now on the left-hand side. We can center it. We can put it on the right-hand side. Okay. Guys, everything is here just to make this thing rock. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you the dashboard really quick. So let me just go ahead and close out of the editor. All right, and now here is our dashboard. So remember what I said about statistics? You can come over here, you can see the visitor chart, you can see how many published pages you have, how many unpublished, how many page views you've had, how many visitors you've had. Okay, here is actual page groups. So you don't have pages all over the place. You can actually group them together. But if you do have them all over the place, you can see here are all the ungrouped pages waiting to be grouped together. Okay, and then you come over here and you have more options, right? We can duplicate these pages. We can add them to a group so it appears up top. We can unpublish them. We can see just the demographics for that one page. I mean, guys, there's so much here, so much to cover. And I'm already 20 minutes into this video. Remember what I said about split testing? Well, here you go. Here's how you split test your different elements, right? This thing is killer, but I still haven't even showed you the one-time offer. So I'm gonna go ahead and get set up to show you the sales funnel builder, which is the first one-time offer. So give me just a minute. All right, guys, so this is the sales funnel builder. All right, so we're gonna come over here. This is so simple. We're gonna click create new funnel. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna name this funnel. So I'll go ahead and call this Chad's funnel. And then there's funnel types. So if we pull this down, we have opt-in funnel, sales funnel, webinar funnel, launch funnels, okay? Now these are just templates. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose webinar funnel. And you'll see that the funnel has loaded. If I choose opt-in funnel, now you see that the opt-in funnel has loaded. Now what's really cool is we can go ahead and click this here. And we can choose a template for our squeeze page. We can do the same exact thing for our confirmation page. Now, something I need to tell you is the OTO is going to include 50 new templates that are not included in the front end version. So when it's all said and done, they will have 150 templates to choose from to create these funnels. Now, if I want to add another page, I can come over here and click add. And then I can simply come over here and change out whatever it is I'm trying to do, right? We have a squeeze page, confirmation. Maybe this here is going to be an upsell page. And then maybe over here we have, I don't know, some launch video or something, right? That doesn't make sense, but you guys get the idea. And this is how fast you can go and create sales funnels with the OTO, right? So we can come over here, click on the element, choose our upsell page, and that's how fast we do this, right? And when we're all said and done, we're gonna come over here, we're gonna click the Create Funnel button, and as soon as we do, here is our actual funnel. There's the pages. We go and change out the permalinks. Everything is here. You can see here's the page type, opt-in, confirmation, upsell, launch videos. We can come over here. We can look at the statistics for the pages, look at the statistics for the overall funnel. Guys, this is awesome, right? This is the one-time offer that's included after the customer purchases InstaBuilder 2.0. All right, so I hope I've done this software justice, guys. To be honest with you, I didn't spend a lot of time in this because it is just laid out beautifully. I caught on very quickly. Remember, three steps. You choose your template, you drop in your element, you do the properties for that element, and that's it. And you can publish it as HTML, you can publish it to Facebook. Guys, everything's here. Like she asked me, what are your suggestions to make this software better? I really couldn't give her any. Everything is here. Okay, so scroll through the rest of this page. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you come aboard for this launch, because this right here, guys, I think she's gonna knock it out of the park. So thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. And for those of you coming aboard, I wanna wish you all the best.